No mai, haere mai. Welcome on tour through Maungawhau Station. Today, we'll journey into the station from the Ruru Street extension, or Ruru Lane, a new street extension that passes in front of the station building. Walking under the 80 Tessa Harris-designed glass louvers adorning the station frontage, the sky element, we enter through feature turnstiles into the station foyer. Standing below the fabulous skylight, the feature ticketing kiosks are on our left. Ahead of us stands the beautiful basalt water wall feature still behind scaffolding. A right turn here takes us toward the new City Rail Link platform. We can take the escalator, lift, or stairs down to platform level. Let's take the stairs. Spools of cables of varying sizes are everywhere along the platform. These cables being installed will supply electricity, Wi-Fi, and other communications such as hearing loop communication and comms for public announcements. The newly installed CRL tracks traveling to and from Karanga Happy Station and further along into the city center are future-proof to take 9-car trains. This is New Zealand's first underground railway. Each new CRL track travels 3.5 kilometers through the tunnels. The first ever trains on these virgin tracks will be test trains that will begin running for test purposes later this year. At the eastern end of the track, we see stairs leading up to Taha, meaning the breath. This is the ventilation building that services the station and the tunnels. The ventilation building exterior is designed by Graham Tippany and incorporates a whakarare pattern. Stairs at both ends of the CRL platform provide emergency exits, but we won't be needing to use those today. Let's head back to the station foyer. As we again walk the length of the basalt water wall, bathed in sunlight from the skylight, we are heading toward the stairs, lifts, and escalator leading to the NAL, or Western Line, overpass. If we hurry, we might see a train go past. Here we are on the Western Line overpass. To my left is the Station Group Control Center, or SGCC. Again, we have accessible options for accessing the Western Line platform. Let's take the stairs. Here, on the Western Line platform, the soffit panels have been installed and the visual features making the new station attractive are more visible. This platform is also future-proofed for 9-car trains. While the Western Line platform has been closed for construction, the trains have continued to operate through the station. Much of the landscape surrounding the platform will be further transformed. The spoil shed we see here will go soon, and upon completion of the project, the surrounds will be developed. In the distance, ahead of us, we see the Fenton Street Bridge connecting commuters from Fenton Street to the walking and cycling esplanade leading to the station. Here too, there are emergency stairs. This train is heading east on the new Western Line track, but we can't get on board just yet. It's time for us to head back to the station foyer for one last look around before we finish the tour. When the rest of the station is complete, one of the fabulous finishing touches will be the installation of 53 glass triangles made of recycled basalt and crafted by artist Sophia Athenou onto the water wall. These triangles represent the volcanic cones of Tamaki Makaurau. As we exit the building and come to the end of our tour, we can imagine the future development in front of us, the new road passing the station, the cafe to our left, and the bicycle racks on the right, and the hustle and bustle of people going places. Thank you for joining the Link Alliance on our journey through the new Maungawhau Station.